The people, the headlines, the issues impacting you, all on This Week in Cincinnati on 9 on Your Side.
Welcome back. Today on This Week in Cincinnati, we're looking back at some of the big stories from the past 12 months. And this year we saw something that we had not seen in years. The mighty Ohio flexing its muscle. In February, the river crested at 60 and a half feet, the highest since the deadly flood of 1997. Among the communities hit the hardest was New Richmond. TJ Parker filed this report from there.
We're about two blocks away from where the Ohio River should be, but you can see the river and the village are one and the same. City officials telling us that one third of the village is submerged. Folks who live here are now wondering when they'll be able to move back into their homes.
We're in wait and see mode.
A village underwater in the daylight. Chopper 9 shows the impact the river has had on homes and businesses throughout town. In Claremont County, more than 70 buildings have been affected by the flood. Trash and debris line the streets that are now drying up.
We're hoping this water recedes rapidly, but it doesn't appear that it's going to. And so we're anxious to start cleanup operations and restore normalcy to the village.
Village Administrator Greg Roberts says the cleanup will begin with moving debris from streets. Then they'll work on people's homes affected by the water. Some homes' electricity has been turned off, and there will be an assessment of each home before turning it back on. Roberts has also seen issues with boaters in the river.
At river levels like this, some are just teetering at the threshold of homes, and even the smallest wake can put water in a house that ordinarily wouldn't.
A state of emergency has been declared for several Claremont County communities, including New Richmond. The good news, though, is that the Ohio River is slowly but surely receding. In New Richmond, I'm TJ Parker, 9 on Your Side.
In Cincinnati, more than 1,000 structures were affected by the flood, but this year's flood pales in comparison to the disaster that hit the city in 1937, when the river peaked 80 feet above flood stage. Another bit of weather that caused hardship this year, the Arctic temperatures that hit just over a year ago in January. We hit a record for January 2nd. Of 7 degrees below zero. It was especially hard on firefighters, but then 8 days later on the 10th, we hit a high for the day, 61 degrees, only in Cincinnati. This Week in Cincinnati, we'll be right back.
The people, the headlines, the issues impacting you, all on This Week in Cincinnati on 9 on Your Side.